Hello, Chris Menard here. I am still discussing my series on removing duplicates in Excel. I've already done a part one and part two. Those were using purely Excel, meaning remove duplicates, conditional formatting. I did concatenate function. I did countif function. This section, I'm going to be dealing with Power Query. You can download this section of my course for free, including the file that I'm using now. We have five items to cover in this. One, throw in your data into Power Query if you've never used Power Query before. And then the other four items, I'm going to remove duplicates twice, but then I'm going to come back and keep duplicates twice. So let's go ahead and take a look at our data and go ahead and dive into this. My data is sitting in cell A1 to cell C9. I've already made it a table. I clicked in here and did Control T. If you notice, I have some IDs that duplicate. I have some categories that I made up that duplicate. And I even have some numbers that have duplicates in them. We're going to take a look at all of this data right now. Let's throw this first into Power Query. Made it a table. Go to the Data tab at the top. Get and transform data from table range. Power Query loads. I have already maximized it. You don't have to maximize it. By default, it has that first column selected. The very first item I want to do is I want to remove duplicates from multiple columns. So I'm going to hold down the shift key and click on total. All three columns are selected. In Power Query, I'm on the home tab. I have a group called reduce rows. It's got two different commands in here. We're going to start off with remove rows, and I'm going to select remove duplicates. Click it one time. We went from a total of 8 to a total of 6. There is no undoing Power Query. Move over to the far right, click on this X that says remove duplicates, and I'm back to where I was when I started. So let's just take a quick look at this. We've got these 8 different rows in here. We're going to do a remove duplicates one more time, remove rows, and we're going to remove the duplicates. If you're wondering what in the world got removed, it got rid of one of the C's. Me, remove this step again. One of the C's has got 40. There's two 40s in here for C, and this A has got 20 in here twice. For ID 1, that is what's getting removed, just to be real clear. So there we go with that one. I'm going to turn it off. That was example 1 for remove. Example 2, I want to remove duplicates from just one column. So I'm going to select column A now, remove rows, remove duplicates. I should only end up with 3 items when I click on remove duplicates. It's going to keep the very first instance of A, the very first B, and the very first C, because after that, row 4 down, they are duplicates. See if I'm right. Perfect. 20, 12, and 15. And I'm going to undo that again. So that was using remove duplicates for one column, and we just did multiple columns. Now, let's take a look now. Instead of removing duplicates, let's take a look at keeping duplicates. Once again, I'm going to use the shift key and select them all. We know we have duplicates in here, so we're going to go and do keep rows, keep duplicates. That is perfect. We just looked at this a second ago. It was product or category A and category C that had duplicate values, and we're saying keep them. Going to take away that applied step. We're back to all the data again. This time, we're going to keep duplicates from a single column. I'm going to select the ID column in this example. Keep rows, keep duplicates. Perfect. ID 1, ID 7. Remove that step just to take a look at this again. ID 1, perfect. And ID 7. There you go. One last step. So we covered all 5. We threw this into Power Query. We did remove twice and we did keep twice. Once you've got this, I'm just going to do keep again, keep duplicates. Once you have this the way you want it, in case you're wondering, just to cover this, how do I actually get this back on an Excel worksheet? Far left, close and load to. It added a new worksheet at the bottom of my screen. I had two worksheets to start. We were starting off with the worksheet called use. We now have a table one. Let me zoom in. There you go. So you could keep doing all four of these and putting these on different worksheets if you wanted to. Thank you for your time. Hope you enjoyed this lesson. Feel free to go and download this file and actually watch this lesson from scratch, and you can do it while I'm doing it. Have a wonderful day.